Hey guys, how are you all doing? Welcome back to another interesting review of the Vic VK1060 Pro Pen Tablet. And I'll tell you in this video if it's worth the asking price, and in the next video we'll also compare it with the Vic A15 Pro, the A30, A50 and other tablets as well. So this is the newest addition to their lineup, the Vic VK1060 Pro within their popular pen tablets lineup. This one is also the new addition with some major changes over here, and a lot has been improved with respect to how the pen behaves on the surface and reflects that on the computer as compared to their previous models. Right guys, so although the report rate is same at 250 PPS, also the pressure sensitivity remains same at 8192 levels, and the resolution is also same at 5080 lines per inches. The overall working smoothness and precision is improved, that I can say for sure, and you'll also see in this video. So before we look at what's the major change I was talking about, first let's look at the box packaging and unbox it, shall we? Guys, don't forget to check the video description for latest updated pricing. Sometime it may go on sale or available as a deal. It had happened so many times, so make sure to check the description for latest updated pricing. Quickly, let's look at the box and the packaging and what comes within the tablet. Looking at the box itself, it's quite compact and the design is kept minimalistic. I have always liked their packaging, so there is no issue with respect to the quality. So there is some neat and useful extras included this time around inside the box, so let's look at it. The first thing that you see when you open the box is the artist gloves, which is fantastic that it comes within the tablet itself and you don't have to buy it separately. Now these gloves really helps prevent any stickiness from sweat while you draw or use the tablet, which is nice thing. There is also screen protector, or rather surface protector, is included this time, which is neat and a welcome addition. Then we have the tablet itself, which is neatly packed, as you can see. Now let's keep this aside for now. Wow guys, so many things to unbox this time. So here's the pen within the soft pen case. As you can see, the design has also been changed, as you can see how the previous model's pen were. Good to see that Vic has been listening to my feedback and the reviews that I have been making. The pen is battery free here. It has two buttons. One of the button has been slightly wedge shaped so that it helps quickly know you are pressing that button, right? However, the pen grip itself is a little bit big, I feel, even though my hands are large, as you can see. Could have been a bit slim to hold, just like how it is on the rear end. As you can see, the pen doesn't feel plasticky and is smooth and soft to touch and hold. Even the nibs are slightly different this time around as compared to the other pens with the other models. I'll tell you why in this video later. Oh, there is also this nice soft pouch included for the tablet. So it's very easy and convenient to carry anywhere along with your laptop or inside the bag. So this is nice again and well thought out. They have also included 28 nibs as spare, which is nice. There is also a quick start guide telling you how to install drivers, which is actually very easy and one-step process I will show you in this video itself. Then there is this USB-C cable for connecting it to the computer, one cleaning cloth, one pen holder with pen removal tool. There are two OTG adapters included this time so that you can easily connect your mobile phone or tablet and work at your convenience. Again, a nice touch over here, as you have seen yourself, right? Now looking at the tablet itself, guys, so here's the dimension of the tablet, as you will see on the screen right now. The tablet measures at 13.3 inches wide, 8.37 inches tall, and has a thickness of mere 9 millimeter, so it's that thin. The workspace area is standard at 10 by 6 inches, and for such a large workspace area, the tablet doesn't feel like big or space consuming. The surface is matte here, obviously for the precision writing or drawing. Now there are two dials with a button which are completely customizable, and that's what you'll love about using this tablet. For example, you can set dial 1 for zoom in or zoom out the page. Dial 2 can be set to increase or decrease the brush sizes as per your convenience and so on. The buttons doesn't wobble or fiddle much, as you can see it is plush and clicky, and that makes you feel satisfied while working on this tablet, and that's what is necessary, right? If it was for a smooth rotation, then you wouldn't have feel satisfied to know what you are doing with the dial, right? So I like how the dial rotates and has a feel to it. It is also texturized too. Guys, one cool thing about the dial button is if you press 4 times, it has 4 different functions which can be customized completely. Again, press 1 time and the dial wheel can be used for zoom in, zoom out. Press the button 2 times, the function of the wheel changes as per your setting. Say it can be used to move the frame left or right, and even in any editing software, or to even slide presentation and so on. Now press the button again, the wheel can be completely customized. Also guys, if you want to use the wheel only for one software and you just don't want to cycle through the buttons for different functions, you can just set the dial button to invalid and boom. the dial button automatically sets to only one time and one function so that you don't get confused. You can also set the function to open any software quickly, which is again handy. Now guys, there are 6 hotkeys in this tablet, or rather buttons, which are again completely customizable for individual softwares. Example, you can set the button shortcuts for Photoshop and then change the shortcut keys for Premiere Pro and then change the keys for different drawing apps like Krita, GIMP, Blender 3D, Photoshop, Illustrator, Painter, etc. Yes, so it is completely customizable. Now guys, on the software end, I'll tell you how to connect the tablet right now. Just download the driver and software from the Vic website. Once you download the software, connect the tablet to the computer using the cable provided, which is very easy. Then install the downloaded software and boom, once it's finished, open the software and it will automatically recognize the tablet for you that you have connected, and you can just check the pressure sensitivity, change the curve as per your liking, like how much pressure is needed. One tip guys, if you are facing any issues with the pressure sensitivity of this pen, or rather the tablet itself, if you feel it's not working properly, then just make sure to enable Windows Ink function and then try it. It should then work very well. There is also pen and mouse mode with sensitivity adjustment. So if you use it as a pen, then the entire workspace acts as a monitor workspace area. While in mouse mode, you can just use it casually like a mouse without having to move the pen from corner to corner, which is awesome and well thought out. So instead of using mouse, you can all day, every time you can use this tablet itself. The major improvement or the changes on this tablet is the pen supports plus or minus 60 degree tilt function, which is fantastic. It's a treat for artists who can utilize tilt function fully at their comfort, right? And one amazing thing is that the pen input feels really matured and has precise movements as compared to their older models. Again, a nice improvement over here. Now the pen itself is battery free with reading height of 10 millimeters, which is more than enough to the surface. It also has 2 buttons and is also customizable. Now the pen is quite grippy but is on the larger side, like I said before, and gets the job done. Now while drawing, I didn't feel any issues with regard to how precisely it is responding as I draw. Even the pressure sensitivity felt natural and organic as I was drawing in the Photoshop with different brushes. So that should already tell you how good this tablet is, right? And what's more guys, it is also Android compatible. Yes, most of the tablets are now compatible, but then this one, meaning just plug in the provided USB OTG to your mobile and then connect tablet directly and boom, you can use tablet on mobile. It works on Android 6 and above flawlessly. It also supports many apps with pressure sensitivity on mobile or even on tablet. So that's how easy it is to work on the tablet and get the job done. It also works with the pressure sensitivity like the cursor, the brush strokes and everything else flawlessly. So what's more to say about this tablet? I think I have covered pretty much everything over here. So is this worth the money? Now you guys tell me. I would definitely recommend this tablet as it's great value for money. Now don't forget to again check the latest updated pricing below in the video description. There are other models too, which I'll be comparing in another video, so stay tuned. I hope this review was helpful to you guys and helped with your purchase decision. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you are new. Alright guys, I will see you all in another one. Till then, take care everyone. Bye bye.